A lot of the examples we see with Boris FX Optics 2022 are focused on image editing and photo manipulation, but there's another aspect to optics which shouldn't be forgotten, and that's as a tool to create design elements, whether it's sort of particle effect or, as we're going to see in this tutorial, making custom background elements. We're starting here with a completely blank canvas, which admittedly is not usually a fun place to be. I'm just going to right click on my background layer and convert this to a smart object. So even though this is just a regular black canvas, I still want to protect this in a smart object so that I can go back later into Optics if I need to make any changes. So let's come down to our filters, Boris Effects, Optics, and let's not use any previous filters. This looks fairly uninspiring. So let's come over to the render category and see what we can do here. I often use this as a good place to start because it just means I can start clicking through here and all of a sudden my blank canvas isn't quite as blank anymore. If I come over to core sticks and go a little bit further to the left, I've also got a number of different presets to start with. And I think I'm going to start with silky sheets. And this already looks pretty good. I can come over to the parameters on the right and I can just quickly change up these parameters. Maybe instead of red, we'll go with a blue. And instead of the pink, we can go maybe a very light cyan. And then it's just a case of shifting this around until I find a pattern that I like, or maybe changing up the ray's focus or something just to soften that out. When I'm at this first experimental stage, I'm not going to make huge swings in here. I'm just going to start making small changes until I find something I like. So now I've got the basis for a background. I'm going to just add a little bit of a twist to it. I'm going to come up to my layers and add another layer in here. And my next port of call is usually in the lens and distort categories, because here I can start to warp things up or maybe even just add a little bit of chromatic aberration or something. And we can take a little look through there, see if something starts to catch your eye. And actually, maybe the warp fisheye is quite nice. And like before, the presets are a really nice way of just seeing what we can start to do with a particular filter. And this gives a sort of, industrial, almost maybe technology sort of look. But I think actually, I'm just going to go with the default again, and instead of twisting it inwards, I'm just going to twist it outwards a little bit, just sort of warp the edges out. I don't need a lot. I think, minus 0.07 it's small amounts. Maybe even just shift it around a little bit. And the final little brick in this house is going to be something in the light category. So let's add another layer. Let's come over to light and let's come over to something maybe like light leaks. This adds a little bit more glamour and an organic look to it. Let's turn the overlays back on again here. We'll find something that looks good. Actually, maybe the hot pink is pretty good. That's working quite nicely with the blue background. So let's just shift these lights out around a little bit. And you can see this is one of the reasons why I like working with optics to create these. Instead of spending time searching for stock backgrounds on a site, we can actually start to customize this up a lot more. And if this is too far, I can just come up to the top in my layers and then just dip the opacity down on this just a little bit. Yeah, I'm kind of liking how that's going. Okay, so I'm going to hit apply on this. And back in Photoshop, this is actually looking quite all right, I think. So I can come in, maybe we'll add another text layer onto the top of it. Very romantic, lorem ipsum. I'll change my font up and maybe make that a little bit bigger. And I just want to show you how we can do a sort of similar thing with text as well. Let's make this just white text. And this white text looks all right, but I think we can add a little bit more interest to this again with optics. So I'm going to come in, I'm going to convert my text to a smart object as well. Let's come back into optics and apply that to our text layer. I will not apply the previous filters, but you can see that when we bring in text with optics that it comes in with the alpha channel as well. So I can come up here, have a little look. There's the alpha channel looking exactly the same. And this is going to be useful for us. So as before, let's go over to render. Let's come over to actually maybe clouds here, and we'll look through the presets to see if there's something here that's going to be quite nice. Actually, I like that. Maybe change the color up just so it's not quite as blue. So we'll just desaturate it a little bit. So we've still got a little bit of the blue in there. Shift this around just so it's not one color. Let's add another layer in here and maybe give it a bit of texture. So let's go with grunge and find a texture that suits this. Actually, maybe canvas looks pretty good. Again, we'll come in here. Let's take that around about the same sort of color as we had previously. And let's just adjust that size down so we get a few more of the cracked lines in there. And I'm going to take this out. Now, I want to take this out so the effect is only limited to the text that we brought in. Now, if you see down at the bottom, in our original layer, because we had alpha associated with our text layer, it's got a little alpha mask there. So if I click on my export masks button, this is going to take out this alpha, our text, rather than the generated alpha channel that we've created with any of the other effects. So I hit apply on that, and that just applies that texture only to our text. Let's create something that's different. Again, starting with a black canvas, right click, convert to smart object. Let's come back into Optics and let's do something else. Apply previous masks. No, thank you very much. Here, let's start with a different color. Let's come over. Actually, we'll come over to our color and we'll go straight to color. And let's choose, what should we choose? Well, let's choose a magenta, but let's not have it this bright. Let's just take this all the way down here. There we go. Something very, very sort of downplayed. Now, we could have chosen this color in Photoshop, but then we wouldn't be able to come in and interactively work with it in Optics. So let's add another layer in here. And I just want to show you Particle Illusion very, very quickly. Now, Particle Illusion is new in Optics 2022, and it's a particle system. So it means we've got ways of generating our heads-up display elements, like these ones, or explosions, or fire, smoke. You've got thousands of different presets that you can start working with. But I'm just going to come into Particle Illusion Miscellaneous. And we've got things like tracker trails and super sun. We do have like a load of different presets to choose from. I actually do like that tracker trails. I think we're gonna do something with that. And I don't really want to do too much with this. I'm just going to come to the world transform and I'm just going to scale it up quite a lot. I mean, if we want to, we can also open up the particle properties and take the number down a little bit. Or if you want to make this preset our own without actually doing anything, you know, too clever, I can just come into the random seed. Only takes a second just to cheat the fact that we've made this unique. Okay, so once we've done that, I'm going to come in and add another layer and just try and make this look a little bit less clear. You know how we did previously when we came into the lens and distortion? I could do that, or I'll come into blurs this time, I think. And there are lots of different ways of handling the blurring. But I think I'm going to use Rack Defocus and kind of make this really, really blurry. We'll just go to blurry eyes. And I think the only thing I'm going to do is just let's crank up that defocus width a lot. And I'll change my shape from circle to a six side, so hexagon. And let's take the gamma down a little bit. So that's sort of make it slightly less bright. So when I take gamma down, I'm going to boost the highlights up. And this is going to give us a bit more of a sort of natural looking blur. So those hot spots are going to start to blur out a little bit nicer. Okay, so far so good. We're following that pattern of adding like a rendered item, warping or blurring it up a little bit. But let's add a little bit more light to this. And again, I'm going to go to the light category. But instead of using something like the light leaks that we used last time, I'm going to come over to UltraGlow. Now, this is my favorite glow filter. Again, we just go through the presets just to see some of the stuff that we can do with it. And this is a way of either making something, you know, really stylized, or just glowing it up in a nice sort of way. And that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to use, I'll use Pea Super just to kind of get this misty looking look. And I'm going to change my primary glow color to something more in keeping with our background. Let's maybe desaturate that just a little bit. Just want a tint of that over the top. And I'm not going to go through any of the other parameters. I'll just change up our brightness here a little bit. So that's giving us this sort of soft, diffuse look, kind of like that. And just to remind you that all of these are live, so I can go back to change any of these controls, something like the diffusion here. Maybe let's make the diffusion width up a little bit, take the gamma down a little bit more, even come down into my particle illusion layer, come into here, and I can adjust this up a little bit. Maybe make the velocity bigger so that we get more separation with these areas here. And when I'm happy with that, I'm going to hit apply, and that's just going to process that out. Now take a little look here. This is something I wanted to show you. If I zoom in, I'm going to zoom in quite hard. You can sort of see I've got the transparency checkerboard pattern at the back here. Yeah. So that means we've got some transparency going on in our image. That's maybe not what we want for a background. So let's come back into Optics and I'll apply the previous presets again. And this is going to be really straightforward to fix. And we're going to fix it in the same way as we did with the text. Some of our effects generate up alpha channels. If we want to use the original alpha that came in, we just use the export masks button down there. Our original alpha channel was completely white. So taking this out now, hit apply. That gets rid of any of the transparency that any of the effects might have created, leaving us with our nice background where I can come in and do another beautiful lorem ipsum. So hopefully you can see how easy and interactive it is to start building up backgrounds and design elements in Optics, and how when we're working in Photoshop, it's a really good idea to pack things together as smart objects. So that means that we can always come back in at a later time and make any sort of small tweaks and changes that we need to in our effects. And if we hit apply, those are going to update immediately for us. My name is Ben Brownlee for Boris FX, and I'll see you again in another Optics tutorial very soon. If you want to test out Optics for yourself, head on over to borisfx.com and you can download a free trial. You'll also find hours more free training for Optics, Particle Illusion, and all of the Boris FX products. And if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to hit the subscribe button as well.